It's a very beautiful moment, dear student. Welcome to our today's lesson. So today, before we say goodbye to this topic, I want us to focus still more on the KCS equation and the MOCS question. And the two topics joined together, that is the concept of the finding the volume of the solids and the surface area of the solid. I want to see at the highest level, which are the questions that can be obtained. The question, I've done more questions on the part of the cone, but today I want us to emphasize on one question for the pyramid and another one for the first chunk that is obtained from the pyramid. Of course, we have been dealing more so on the case of the pyramid and the cone. So yesterday we did one for the pyramid, for the first chunk from the pyramid. I want us to emphasize on that before we go to the next topic. So you as a learner, the objective is to be able to identify the trick that they have been given in the question, and then from there to have the formulas on your fingertips so that you don't confuse the concept that you're being asked by the examiner. So let's try to see our example then. I want us to focus on it. Check on that example. So in this example we are told, the examiner is telling us that a solid, which is having the shape of a right pyramid, has a rectangular base. The concept that I want you to understand. So the base is a rectangle, and this time it's not a square. So a solid right pyramid has a rectangular base of 10 centimeter by 8 centimeter, and then the slanting edge is 16 centimeter. Then you are told to calculate the vertical height of that pyramid, you're given 2 marks. Then again, the total surface area, that pyramid, you're given 4 marks, and then the volume. That pyramid. So this is the pyramid that you have been given there. That is one is the right pyramid, and the base is a rectangle. So you are told that it has the base of the wing is 8 centimeter, and then this one is 10 centimeter. Okay? So if you have been given this one is 8 and then this one is 10, and then you have been given here the slanting height, is it? You are told that the slanting edge is 16 centimeter. Then they need now this vertical height. So if you remember the technique that we said yesterday, you have first of all to find, because you have only the slanting height, you have to employ the concept of the Pythagoras theorem. So you must be having a right angled triangle. And for this right angled triangle, it will be comprised of this slanting edge and the perpendicular height plus the half of the diagonal of that rectangle. So step number one is to get the diagonal of this rectangle. And when you get this diagonal of this rectangle, you divide by 8 to get the half of it. And for you, you'll be having two information. You'll be having the base of that rectangle triangle and then the slanting edge of this rectangle triangle, so you can only find the perpendicular height. So we start by obtaining the diagonal of this rectangle. So our rectangle is this way. Okay. So the rectangle is given by the information here is 10. Here's 10 centimeter, and then this one is 8 centimeter. So step number one, we get this one. The diagonal, get the diagonal, because that one is 90. So the diagonal is going to be given by the hypotenuse, so it will be given by the square root of 10 square plus what? Plus 8 square. So that we have our diagonal. It's going to be square root of 100 plus 64. So the diagonal is going to be given by the square root of 164. So it is going to be your diagonal from the calc. So from your calculator, you come here and get the square root. The square root of 164, get that is 12.81. This one is 12.81 centimeter. But remember, we are not interested. We are not interested with the diagonal. We are interested in half of it. So that you obtain the rectangle triangle. So we have diagonal divided by 2. This one is going to give what? 12.81 divided by 2. So then divided by 2, you get this one is going to be 6.4. This one give us 6.4 centimeter. This one is now 6.4. So now that is the information that you have. You have that from here to here is 6.4, and then from here is where is 16. So can we not get this perpendicular height using the knowledge again of the Pythagoras theorem? So our triangle is going to be of this nature, this way, and that way, and here. So you know here is 16 centimeter. This one is 90, and then this one is 6.4 centimeter. So what you need to get this height, which is our perpendicular height, using the Pythagoras theorem again. So our height is going to be given by the square root. Remember, you all know the hypotenuse is going to be 16 squared. Okay? Minus 6.4. So it's going to be our height. So our height is going to be 16 squared minus 6.4 squared. That will give us 215. Square root of 215.04. So you have our height is the square root of that. You have the square root of our answer. Square root of answer. That's give us 14.66. This one is going to be 14.66. That's how you score your 2 marks there, by getting the perpendicular height. Now, when you get your perpendicular height again, when you get your perpendicular height, you need now to come and now you get where the marks are going to be. That is now our part B. So let's go to part B, see what the examiner requires you to do. In part B, the examiner needs you to find the surface area. And when you're getting the surface area, we say the simple case is to identify the number of the faces that are making your solid that you have. Then you find the surface area of each and every face, and then you sum it in order for you to have the total surface area. So in this case, we come here and then we say that the now face number one, this one is going to have, pyramid is the bottom. We have this one as our bottom, rectangle. Then you have this triangle. And these of it are similar. And then you have the other triangle. It's going to be similar. So in total, we are having five faces. One rectangle, two triangles which are isosceles, and another two triangles which are isosceles. So these are where they are. So in the our pyramid, we're going to have the first one is a rectangle. Measuring what? What is the measurement of it? The rectangle is 10 by 8. Centimeter. Then we have the two, that is number one. Then we have two rectangles, two triangles, this nature. The base is going to be 8 centimeter. Then we have 16 centimeter, 16 centimeter. So there are two. Then another two triangles, again of the same. This one. It's not going to be 10 centimeter. Then this one is 8 centimeter. Are not 8 but 16. That's the information that I'm talking about. So in this case, when the base is a rectangle, it is different from when it is a square. Because if it is a square, then all these triangles could look alike, all of them. It should be now, if I find one of them, we multiply by 4, because the base is going to be the same. But this time, it is a rectangle. So the bases are not, two of them are going to have the same base, and then two of them are going to have the same base. That is another trick. When the base is a rectangle and not a square. So to find the total surface area, we start with the rectangle, that is our number one. That is going to be 10 multiplied by 8, then that one is going to be 80 centimeters square. Then in our Roman number two, you're going to use the what? You're going to use the Hero's formula. So the Hero's formula says that the area is given by the square root of S, then S minus A, then S minus B, then S minus C. So we need to get our S, which is going to be the half of the perimeter. Half of the perimeter was going to be 16 plus 16. Those are the length percentages. Then plus the base, which is 8. Then from there, this one is giving us a half. Multiplied by 16 plus 16, that is that 2. Then that 2. That 2 plus 8. That's giving us 40. Multiplied by 40 here. This one is going to give us what? Going to give us 20. So the area is going to be given by what? From the formula we substitute the values. So the area is going to be, area is going to be our S, which is 20, then multiplied by 20 minus 16, 20 minus 16, then 20 minus 8. Okay? But now our area is given by what? The square root of? This is 20. Then 20 minus 16 is 4. Then multiply by another 4. Then multiply by 12. Then we see the area is going to be what? That is going to be 20. Multiply by 4 squared. Then multiply by 12. That is giving us 3,840. Square root is 3,840. Then from there, what is going to be our area? So you take the square root of the answer. You take the square root of the answer. You obtain this one is 61.9. It's going to be 9678 centimeters square. Then that one is for one of the triangles. And remember, there are two. So in order to get this one from one, two, you're going to get the area now is going to be given by 61.9678 multiplied by 2. What we see, when you multiply by 2, what are we going to get? So multiply by 2. So you get this one is going to be 123.9355 centimeters. You have now covered for this one, you have covered for this one. So what is going to remain is now the third part. Remember, our third part is still again the Hilbert formula. That is now number 3. We need to find again our S. So our S is going to be given by what? A half multiplied by 16 plus 16, then plus 10. So this one, our S is going to be a half multiplied by what? What is that? 2 plus 10, 42. And this gives us what? 21. So area is going to be square root of here. Say this is 21, then minus 21 minus 16, then 21 minus 16, then 21 minus what? Minus 21 minus the base is 10. But now this one area is going to be given by that is 21 multiplied by 21 minus 6, that is 5, then multiplied by 5. Then multiply by what? 21 minus 10, that is 11. That's the case. So that the area is going to be given by what? The square root of 21 multiplied by 5 square, then multiply by 11. So this is 5775, square root of 8. That one I'm going to take it on the second part of the video. I'm done with the first part, the number of it.